work, power and energy. So first, what is work? When the force of 1 newton moves the body 1 meter in the direction of force, then the work is said to be 1 joule. So work, it is nothing but it is a multiplication of force into distance. Now the force taken into newton and distance taken into meter. So we can write 1 newton into 1 meter is equal to 1 newton meter works, and it is represented by 1 joule. So its unit is joule. Now the newton meter, it is a unit of mechanical work. Now what about electric work? So electric work is equal to V into I into T, where V is the volt, I is the current passing through the conductor, and T is the time. So here, if V is 1 volt and current is 1 ampere and time T is 1 second, then the electric work W is equal to 1 joule. What is power? So the rate of work is called power. So the power, it is nothing but the ratio between work and time. The power is represented by capital P, and work is represented by capital W, and time is represented by small t. So if W is 1 joule and time T is 1 second, then T is 1 joule per 1 t, and its unit is watt, and it is denoted by capital W. Now the very small value of power is represented by milliwatt and microwatt. So here 1 milliwatt is equal to 10 raised to minus 3 watt, 1 microwatt is equal to 10 raised to minus 6 watt. For the higher value of power is represented by kilowatt and megawatt. So 1 kilowatt is equal to 10 raised to 3 watt, 1 megawatt is equal to 10 raised to 6 watt. Horsepower. Horsepower is a mechanical unit of power. So here we can write 1 HP is equal to 133.5 watt. So it is most important. Now in electrical, the power, it is nothing but, already I told you, it is a ratio between power work to the time. So here we can write, and W is equal to VIT. So just put the value of W in this equation. So P is equal to VIT divided by T. TT cancel. So the equation of power, electrical power, is equal to V into I. Now according to Ohm's law, we can write this V is equal to I into R. I is the current passing through the conductor, and R is the resistance of the circuit. Now already we have found that the power P is equal to V into I. Now put the value of this VI into R, V is equal to I into R in this equation. So P is equal to IR into I. So the equation becomes of the power P is equal to I square into R. Now this equation or this power can be also defined in another way. So according to Ohm's law, I can also write I is equal to V upon R. Already we have seen P is equal to V into I. So just put the value of I is equal to V by R in this equation. So here P is equal to V into V by R. So the P power is equal to V square by R. So the power can be defined in three ways. P is equal to V into I, or P is equal to I square into R, or P is equal to V square by R. So what is energy? So energy, it is nothing but it is a multiplication of power and time. So here we can write energy is equal to power into time. So P into T. So that means power means V into I into T, that is joules. Now already we have seen energy is equal to power into time. Let me see different units of the energy. So power is taken into watt, time taken into second. So its unit is watt second. We can take time in also minute. So that means watt into minutes. Now we can also take time in the hour. So watt into hour, that means WH. Now this watt, it can also take in kilowatt. So kilowatt into hour, that means kWh. We can also take the time in the second, and power into kilowatt, that means kilowatt into second, so kWh. Or we can also take time in minutes, kilowatt into minutes. Now out of them, the most popular unit is kWh. So we can write 1 kWh is equal to 1 kilowatt into 1 hour.